Good morning, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Rachelle, Heartbeat Ebony and the kids. Good morning. Good morning, Heartbeat Belinda. Good morning, good morning. Happy Monday morning to you guys. Hope you guys had a great weekend. Hope you woke up with bells and whistles on this morning. Hey, Heartbeat Elaine, Heartbeat Donald, good morning. Good morning, good morning to you guys. Hey there, Heartbeat Sabrina. What's going on? Hey, Heartbeat Aaliyah, Heartbeat Eva, Heartbeat Carolyn. Good morning to you guys. That's right, great, marvelous, magnificent Monday. Love it, love it, love it. Hey, Heartbeat Troy, Heartbeat Juanita, good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning. Well, let's get into it. Hey, Heartbeat Christine, good morning. I am Regina Banks. Welcome to the Gathering of Hearts. I am your GPS to wholeness, aka the Heart Gatherer. I love you guys so much. Hey, listen, this morning, your daily dosage is I'm going to wait on you. And every time I hear that phrase, in my head, if I were a singer, I would be singing it like Maverick City. I would be getting into it. But that is the daily dosage for this morning. I'm going to wait on you. Wait is to stay where one is or delay action until a particular time or until something else happens. And sometimes we want to rush God. We want things to happen when we want them to happen, but we have got to wait on God's timing. In this, we're being renewed, we're being strengthened, we're getting instructions. He's making sure that we are ready. So Isaiah 40, we'll read this in a couple of translations. The King James Version says this, and I'm reading verse 31. It says, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and faint not." And so when we begin to wait on the Lord, it says our strength will be renewed. See, when we're waiting on the Lord, knowing that He is preparing something for us, He's getting it ready, our strength will be renewed when we wait. Amplified says it like this, "But those who wait for the Lord, who expect, look for, and hope in Him will gain new strength and renew their power." See, there's a purpose in waiting. See, while you're waiting, you could be worshiping. While you're waiting, you can be praising. While you're waiting, you could be learning. While you're waiting, you could be getting to know the new you. While you wait, God is renewing you. God is strengthening you for what it is that you're waiting on. But while you wait, have great expectation that God is the God that He said He is. Have great expectation that there's a purpose in this way, that although that there is a delay, God is blocking you from something that you may not be ready for. God is blocking you from something that won't meet your heart's desire. Glory to God. God is blocking you from danger that may be ahead. Remember, He's already gone before you. He knows what's going to happen. He sees, He knows, and He knows that the timing is not perfect. And so we've got to learn how to be patient and wait on God. We've got to learn how to trust His timing. We've got to learn how to trust the decisions that He makes for our lives. Remember, we said that we surrender all, that we gave our lives to God, meaning they no longer belong to us, but they belong to God. So I'm going to wait on Him. I'm just going to wait on You, Lord. And then it says, getting back into the verse, "They will lift up their wings and rise up close to God, like eagles rising toward the sun. They will run and not become weary. They will walk and not grow tired. See, you've got to understand that in this way, how He's renewing your strength, when He pulls the trigger and says go, you have to be ready to go. There's no time to get tired at that point. There's no time to take a break, because see, He's giving you that time when you were waiting to restore you, to renew you, to get you ready so that you will be strong. And so when He pulls the trigger, you will be ready. I'm just going to wait on Him. The Easy Reading Version says it like this, "But those who trust in the Lord will become strong again." You're going to get your strength back. It says they will be like eagles that grow new feathers. Look, He's restoring. He's renewing. He's getting, you're receiving restoration. It says new wings. So you're new, I'm sorry, new feathers. So restoration is taking place in the weight. They will run and not get weak. They will walk and not get tired. See, you've got to understand this. God is positioning you strategically to come forth, to come out of the shadows, but it's only in his timing. I know you want it now. I know you want it to happen right now. I know you think that you're ready for it, but there is a designated time. There isn't a moment, a designated moment. There is a purpose. There is a time when he is going to do it, and we've got to learn how to just wait on him. We've got to not be upset when he blocks things. Here, let me just share this quick testimony with you. There was something that I really, really, really wanted to do on yesterday. Planned for it, got excited for it, looked like it was going to happen. Had people believing God with me. Oh, you know, I hope you, that's something you want to do. I hope you get the opportunity to do it. And then it didn't happen. And I was kind of like, okay, God, I guess that's not how you wanted to handle it. Yesterday, reading something, found out that had I gone to this particular thing that I wanted to go to, I would have been very disappointed because it was not going to be like I thought it was going to be. And I just had to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, God, for blocking that. Thank you, God, for not giving me what I thought I wanted. Thank you, God, for telling me it's not time yet. You've got to wait. And all day yesterday, all I kept saying was, I'm just going to wait on you. So until further notice, while we're waiting, grow, mature, develop your skills, and then grow some more, mature some more, and develop your skills some more. Seek God and don't try to exit this waiting season prematurely. You know how when a cake is being baked, you know, when I was little, when my mom would be making a cake, you know, as a kid, you're excited. You know, you get to lick the cake bowl, and so you can't wait. And so I would be going to get ready to open the oven, and my mom would say, no, don't open the oven, Gina. You can't open the oven. You're going to cause the cake to fall. And so I'm saying the same thing to you. Don't rush to go open the oven, because when you opened up the oven, it caused the cold temperature that would rush into the oven. That would be what will cause a cake to drop. That is what will cause a cheesecake to crack. What am I saying to you? You just gotta wait on God. If you keep going to that oven, opening the oven, the cold temperature is going to cause the cake to just flatten out. It's going to cause it to like flatline. So you've got to wait, because you don't want the cold temperature to come in and cause what God is working on for you to fall. You don't want it to cause your cake to drop. And so you've just got to learn to wait on God. You've got to worship him while you wait. You've got to praise him while you wait. You've got to exalt him while you wait. Get excited about that thing. See, you've got to start looking at it differently because you're in a waiting season. You've got to know that this thing must be big. This thing must be good. This thing must be grand, that God is working on it. And so you've got to renew your mind and not feel like, oh my goodness, I'm waiting too long. No, I'm going to just praise God. I'm not going to rush God. I'm just going to exalt him because he's King of Kings. He is Lord of Lords. I'm going to thank you, Lord, for loving me. I'm going to thank you, Lord, for not giving me what I thought I wanted. I'm going to thank you, Lord, for blocking that situation. Lord, I'm just going to wait on you. I'm going to wait on your perfect timing for you to pull the curtain and tell me go. I'm going to wait on your perfect timing, Lord, for you to say it's my time and it's my season to shine. Lord God, I'm going to wait to see when I thought you wasn't working, when I couldn't see you working, when I couldn't feel you working. Lord God, I'm just going to wait on you. Glory to God. See, there is a purpose in the wait. There is a celebration in the wait. There is just a good thing to just wait on the Lord. He is preparing something good for you. He is strategically putting people in place. He is strategically putting everything in line so that when you get there, baby, you are going to shine. And so today, this morning, your daily dosage, I'm just going to wait on you. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. Again, like I said, mature some more. Develop your skills. Seek God even the more. He's doing something in your life that is unstoppable. Don't think about it as, you know, I think it's time. Don't think about it as it's taking too long. Don't rush God. Trust in his timing. Trust in his ways. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. And even though it seems like it's taking a long time, just continue to trust God. Let this be your confession today. I'm just going to wait on him. I'm just going to wait on you. You've got to remember that your steps are ordered. And when that designated moment comes, when that appointed time comes, you will be released to walk in all the things of God, all the things that he's prearranged, predestined for your life. Hey, listen, that's your daily dosage today. I'm just going to wait on him. I can tell you today that I'll be listening to that song by Maverick City all day today. I'll be singing in my Heartbeat Rachelle voice because I'm really not a singer, but I'll be singing in her voice on today. Listen, if you have not subscribed to the YouTube channel already, please do so. There you can find all of your dosages in one place. Follow me on social media platforms. God Wants Me Whole. Visit the website, GodWantsMeWhole.org. I love you guys a bunch. Have a amazing day as you wait on God. See you guys in the morning. Let's close this thing out. Say, God wants me whole, and I am getting whole by the minute. Again, I'm Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness, aka the Heart Gatherer. See you guys tomorrow morning. Again, have a amazing day. Hey there, Heartbeat Daisy. Hey, Heartbeat Keynote. Hey, Heartbeat Annette. Love you guys much. I'll see you in the morning.